Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do HDR photography in Adobe Lightroom. Hi, I'm Adam, and welcome to First Man Photography, the channel that will help you take your photography to the next level. Before we get into the video, in this tutorial, I'm going to be using Adobe Lightroom. Now, this is a program that's very powerful for storing, organizing, and editing your photos. If you haven't got that yet, I'll put a link down below for you so you can get a free trial. After that, it's £8.50 a month in the UK and $10 a month in the US. But with that, you also get Adobe Photoshop. So that's a really great value package and a really powerful photo editing suite. Okay, let's get into this. So HDR stands for High Dynamic Range. And all it means is that within that image, you're going to be capturing those real nice highlights, but also bringing out the detail in the shadows and then everything in between. When we see things in the real world, the combination of our eyes and our brain pull in all that information anyway, so we have a really nice view of the world with really high dynamic range between those highlights and those shadows. Now, sadly, the processors in our cameras are not quite as powerful as that, so we aren't able to pull all the detail out. That's why you get high contrast images where detail's lost in the shadows, or you get blown out highlights, or vice versa. It's impossible to expose for the image as a whole in certain circumstances. There is a way around this though, and that's with HDR. Now, if you've seen HDR before, you might be thinking that you don't quite like it, because when it first came about, some of the images that it created were very unrealistic and it looked a little bit like you'd thrown up all over the image. Thankfully though, this is no longer the case and we can really use HDR to our benefit to pull out details in some of those really high contrast situations that you may find yourself in. And all we need to do to achieve this is to take two or three images of your scene and then combine them in Lightroom. And what that does is you're capturing the highlights in one picture, the mid-tones in another, and then the shadows in another, and exposing for each of those in the correct way. And then Lightroom will combine them and produce the final image. I'm gonna go through the settings in the camera quickly, and then we'll get into Lightroom and I'll show you what to do. So the first thing you need to do is get out somewhere beautiful so you've got something great to shoot and it will end up being a great image at the end. Next, we need to employ the bracketing option that our camera offers, and this will only work in manual mode. So the first thing you wanna do is expose for somewhere around the mid-tones. If you need to work in auto or aperture priority, then do that, but make a note of your settings and then transfer them into manual mode. Switch into manual mode and then you need to hit the Q button or go into the exposure compensation chart, which now becomes the bracketing. Slide the roller and you can set the bracketing so have those three shots either side of that exposure that you've gained. Now, sometimes it works well with one stop or two stops of bracketing, and it really depends on the lighting in your situation as to what you use, but I'll generally be working somewhere between one stop and two stop. Once you've done that, shoot your shot, but you really want to have the camera as stable as possible, so it's best done on a tripod, although if you are very steady, it can be done handheld. So I'm assuming now that you've got your shot and we'll head into Lightroom. Okay, so we're straight into Adobe Lightroom, and this is a really straightforward edit. Simple to do and really quite effective. Now, this is the image I'm going to be working with. It's a shot I took on my recent trip to the Yorkshire Dales when I captured my first vlog. If you haven't seen that yet, I really recommend you see it. I'm really proud of it. Go into the description down below and I'll put a link up for you there. So my three images, we've got this one here, exposing for the shadows, the mid-tones and the highlights. You can see that bright sky that is there, and the rest of it's underexposed because I'm just trying to pull the details out of that sky on that shot. So just select all three, select the first one, hold shift down and select the last one, and then right click and you're going to go straight to photo merge. Then just simply click HDR and this window should pop up and start creating a preview of your HDR. Now we have a few options over on the right here. Auto align, you can just leave that because you want everything to line up. Auto tone, you can choose whether you have that. I usually leave it in because it does make some tonal changes that you can undo afterwards if you want, but sometimes it gets it right, so I just leave it. Deghost, now what that is if you've handheld your HDR, there might be some slight movement between each of the frames and Lightroom will try and correct that. If there's something moving in your frame that you don't want there, Lightroom will also try and correct that. So the amount of that Lightroom does that can be controlled here with a low, medium, and high. I generally have my HDRs on a tripod, so I usually go for none, and that doesn't put any deghosting on whatsoever. And you're generally going to get the highest quality using the setting of none. Then just go ahead and click merge. Lightroom takes a second to do its thing and then creates that last image for you of the completed HDR. So then you can just go into that, view it, and you can see I've got detail right across the highlights here where you can now see some blue sky. I've got those mid-tones nice and the shadows are there as well. There's not a lot of contrast in it, so you want to hit the D to go into the develop module, and then you can start making some changes. This is a DNG file, so you still have all that raw data there to really make those nice, accurate changes with your sliders here. As you can see, it's put highlights right down there with those tone changes that it did automatically. So I'm just going to adjust that a little bit, and you can see the difference it's making. It probably has it right, keeping it quite down low. Reduce some of the shadows and then just give it a nice contrast boost to start bringing out that detail in the images. Add a little bit of saturation, vibrance. It's up to you how you do your settings. But as you can see, it's a really simple edit, and you can start to see what a nice image this is becoming. It's nice and simple, easy to do using the power of Adobe Lightroom. I think you'll agree that the image doesn't look unrealistic. It's nice and it represents what I saw at the time. So it's not cheating, it's not tricking anybody. It's just a way of presenting the scene that you saw to your viewer. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that, and now you've got a good idea of how you're going to use HDR to your benefit. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. I know it's going to help you out and get your photography to the next level. This video is going up on a Sunday and a Wednesday, and I'll see you on another video very soon. I'm Adam, this is First Man Photography, out.